Question five. In the figure below, AC and BD intersect at point E. Use the figure to find X, Y, and Z, and no, it's not drawn to scale. Okay, so some of this information is good to know. ABC is a line segment they're talking about here from A to C, this line, and then B to D, that line intersect at point E. And we know from these little markings that these are parallel lines. So that means we're probably going to have to use some of our properties from the previous section. So I'm going to redraw this with the lines continuing and then this transversal. So I'm trying to find X and I'm going to look at other angles that I know. So that 40 is this angle. Okay, and that I didn't draw that line. I just drew the parallel, and the transversal. So that 40 is not related, but this 24 is. Do you remember what type of angles those are? Alternate interior. And they are congruent. So X is 24. And then it says enter degree. So I bet we have to put degrees. Okay, what's the value of Y? All right, so Y is not related to the transversal because if it continues, that would mean this whole angle, right? Not just Y. And so for Y, we're going to have to use the triangle. What do we know about triangles? What are the angles at to? 180, right? So we have a triangle and we know two angles and we actually know the third from using our vocabulary here, vertical angles. So this is 40, this angle. I'm going to redraw the triangle over here. It's hard to see. So I have a 40-degree angle here. Because of those vertical angles, I have 53 and I'm trying to find Y. So these add to 180. So I'm going to take 180 minus 40 minus 53, and that's going to give me Y. So 180 minus 40 minus 53. So Y is 87. All of those angles are going to add to 180. Okay, last one, angle Z. Oops, I thought I had the eraser. Okay, so Z is part of this transversal, but 53 isn't because it's cut off. And 24 is, let's see. It's across from it. I'm seeing a triangle here, but I'm not seeing an angle on the transversal that's going to help us. So, right here, I'm going to use this triangle. And we know triangles add to 180, so let's use that. This is 24. This is what we're trying to find. We can find this angle using what we call supplementary angles. Remember, those are two angles that add to 180 degrees. So, right here, 40 and E add to 180. They're two angles cut on a straight line. So, if this is 40, we would take 180 minus 40, and this would be 140. Okay, and now it's the same process. Once we have a triangle, we take 180 minus 140 minus 24. And that's going to give us Z, which is just 16. So that's why it says in the instructions, figure is not drawn to scale. Okay, because that does not look like 16 degrees. Okay, so 24, 87, 16. And I'm going to put deg, that is the degree.